Welcome everyone to our second career chat series, which is presented by Artworks. I'm Elise Gertz and I am the practicum and internship coordinator for College of Arts. And today with us, we have Dr. Michael Corman and Dr. Linda Party, who's going to be interviewing him. So Dr. Michael Corman is an assistant professor of sociology in the Department of Social, Cultural, and Media Studies at the University of the Fraser Valley. And he is also affiliated with the Center for Education and Research on Aging and New Community Health and Social Innovation Hub at UFB. His research and teaching interests include sociology of health and illness, emergency medical services, aging, caregiving, and autism spectrum disorders, healthcare work, sociology of the family, gender and sexuality, critical qualitative research strategies, and public health. Welcome, Michael.
Hello, great to be here.
And interviewing Michael today, we have Dr. Linda Party, who is the Associate Dean of Students for the College of Arts. And she encourages and supports faculty and students to recognize the embedded work-life career development that is fostered by humanities and social science education. Her research agenda is committed to ensuring liberal arts grads know that they are equipped to tackle today's challenges and numerous career opportunities. So welcome you guys.
Thanks, Lise, for organizing this for us. This is amazing and I'm really happy to be here. I've had the privilege of interviewing Mike before, but today Mike has signed up to take our 10 by 10 career challenge. And that 10 by 10 career challenge is 10 questions in 10 minutes. Rapid fire, Mike. And it's really the purpose of these career chats just to help students and our community members get a handle on and understand the role of a liberal arts education and how the different things that have influenced you in your career have springboarded you into what you do today and what you've done in the past. So the questions you have received them in advance, so you're prepared. No notes, but here we go. You ready?
Yep.
Okay. So what is your preferred learning style and why?
Well, I love to be able to, put knowledge into practice. So experiential learning, I love listening to profs and reading content, but also being able to apply it. So in terms of my own teaching, putting content into practice is the major so what of what I try and do. Try and teach my students, why does this matter to you? I have hundreds and hundreds of slides that have the word so what on it. Why is this relevant? How is it important? How should you be, can you use it in your everyday life? So really my learning style, I don't know, I'm an active learner. I try and engage both as a learner, but also as a teacher. And I try and create an environment in my classrooms that are, less hierarchical and more sort of conducive to, collaborative and to talk and to be able to learn together.
When you think of your own career, who were your early influences or mentors?
Yeah, so Dr. Party and I had talked about this before this interview, but Dorothy Smith is one of the biggest mentors I've had in my life, but also in terms of academia, she really, motivated me to come and do my PhD. I took classes from her during my master's at the University of Victoria in British Columbia, and it really convinced me that this is what I want to do really for the rest of my life. Also, one of her students as well, Dr. Liza McCoy, was my PhD supervisor. Really, I learned how to be generous and, how to be generous and critical at the same time with my students. Liza was one of those mentors that really, taught me how to be a good educator and supporter in terms of learning and writing and teaching as well.
Thank you. What is the best part of your work? Like, what do you like the best about your work? And what do you like the least about your work?
Sure. I love teaching. I love being in the classroom. I love seeing my students' faces. So of course, interacting with my students, it's what I get up in the morning for in part. And so teaching is probably my favorite part of what I do. But also learning from my students. I mean, we have an extremely diverse student body here at UFE, which is such a huge asset, both as, as fellow students, but also as academics and as professors. And so teaching my students, learning from my students, seeing those aha moments, but also being challenged by my students. And so a big part of it for me is also learning. So that's one of the things I love about my job. I also love research. what I do for a living in terms of research is I listen to people and I observe people. I mean, how cool is that, right? So I love my teaching. I love my research. I love my, you know, interacting with my colleagues. We're diverse. We have different experiences and we learn from each other. You know, in terms of, you know, what I like, what I don't like the least, I mean, this is a hard question because I love what I do at UFE. I absolutely love what I do at UFE and feel so privileged to be doing what I do. If I had to pick something, you know, as an academic, we have to do what's called peer review, which is also exciting, but also sometimes a little bit heartbreaking because, of course, it's a, you know, process whereby your fellow peers critique your work. And that's what makes it academic and systematic, but also it's challenging at times. But I've also been a peer reviewer, so it can be fun as well. So anyways, that's character. Probably one of the more challenging things.
Yeah. Character building.
Yes, it builds character.
What makes you feel successful in your work as a sociologist, not as a teacher?
So teaching and as a sociologist, I'll start off with teaching. I mean, really, you know, once in a while, I would say, you know, once in a while, I get emails from my students that say, Mike, it's your class that made me go take that encouraged me to do a sociology degree or a sociology minor or go on to my master's or PhD. And that to me, like, I mean, it brings one of the biggest joys to my life is getting those emails from students, but also kind of the everyday kind of, you know, I try and get feedback from my students because I want to see if what I'm teaching is what I have that I'm doing and like what I think I'm doing in my mind, right? And so in other words, I want students to give me feedback to say, is this working well or not? So it's part of my learning process, but also it's those moments where I hear from the students, yes, it's working well. And, you know, I see in their eyes, you know, challenging perhaps what they perhaps took for granted in the past and being able to look at it in different nuanced ways. And so that's what I love about, you know, teaching is working with my students, you know, and challenging them and them challenging me. Research, like I love learning. In academia, sociology, we learn and we question and we want to make change. And so my job and in terms of research is really trying to foster scientific knowledge that can foster real meaningful change.
Okay, I'm going to speed this up here aloud. You get one word or two words to answer the next couple of questions, okay? What are the major factors that contributed to your career choice in sociology?
Yeah, social change, social justice.
Social change, we're going with social change, okay. What experiences have shaped your ability to engage in innovation skills and thinking?
Yeah, I've been lucky. I've taught in Doha, Qatar, or Qatar, in the Middle East. I was a professor in Northern Ireland. And of course, I'm back in Canada now. And so being around the world, being able to be exposed to different cultures.
We're going with being around the world. When did you know that you were good at what you do?
When did I know that I was good at what I do? Well, you know, I started teaching when I was 25 years old and I wanted to see if I liked it. I loved it. And I think generally, if you like what you do, if you love what you do, you're sometimes, you can be thought of as being good at what you do. But getting feedback from my colleagues and my students to me was that moment where I'm like, I think I'm okay at this. Now, I'm not perfect and we always have to improve. I am quote unquote, I am still learning as we all are. That was just there. I did not place that there on purpose. But yeah, so that's my response to that.
How have your personal values impacted your work?
I mean, I have been raised to think about social justice, to challenge inequalities. And so, of course, this is the underpinnings of sociology is to make change, to challenge social inequalities, to challenge, you know, power relations that benefit the few and the powerful. So part of my own values, you really made me sort of align with what I do for a living right now, which is teach sociology.
So what are you reading right now?
Reading a book. It's
called
Upstream Medicine. It's geared towards making change beyond the clinic to making change in society and increasing
summer,
health.
Yeah. Summer reading for all of us. No.
Exactly.
Describe a place that impacted you and what was impactful about it.
Doha, Qatar. My first professorship, being exposed to such diversity and difference, it's really hit me in the face. And really made me a better sociologist.
What surprises you about your career?
I mean, I don't know if it surprises me, but one of the things is just how diverse my job is. You know, I teach. I work with medical doctors in Ireland. I publish and do research with nurses. I have students who are so interesting and come from different places, and I can learn from their lived experiences. So just like the ever-changingness of what I do for a living, right? It's never, I've taught introduction to sociology for almost 13 years now. It's never the same.
So you're never bored?
Never bored. Never, ever bored. And you shouldn't be bored in my classes, I hope.
Yeah. No, perfect. Okay, let's wrap it up with when you think of the future, what do you dream of?
I dream of a more equitable society, a society that challenges inequality and challenges racism and classism and sexism and ageism and all these different axes of inequalities that really we're seeing today, but have been underlying and are have been present historically as well. You know, to me, it's, you know, what I do for a living is ever more important. So I hope for a more equitable world, where, you know, based on principles of social justice and, you know, a more generous way of organizing society.
Thank you. You've made it through the 10 by 10 challenge. That's excellent. Thank you. Thanks very much. And I'm it's just great that you've decided to hang out and take this challenge. It's not easy.
That was challenging, but I appreciate it. Thanks a lot for that. And it was good.
Thanks.
So up next week, we have a career chat with Heidi Martin, who is a graduate of the geography program and holds a certificate in Indigenous studies. And she is going to be sharing with us her position with indigenizing development, which is going to be really interesting. And I so look forward to learning more about. So join us next week. And we'll have more coming at you.